Welcome guys, our YouTube channel St. Wilfrid College of Arts, Commerce and Science. So students, today we are going to discuss about letters. So here you can see, here is the format of letter, like formal letter to inquiry and get details, and last one is must include. So it means in inquiry letter, we have to follow this format. So in formal letter, we have to follow the two rules, like we have to follow the format, and in formal letter our word limit is 100 to 120 words. Next passage is about to inquiry and get details. It means in inquiry letters, which item we have to buy, we have to mention in second paragraph. In second paragraph, we also have to, if we have any information about course to study, or if we have to inquiry about a vacation trip. And last thing is must include, here we have to mention sender's contact detail and details inquired about. So in that way, in inquiry letter, we have to follow these all things. After that, here we can see one example of letter, and this letter is about inquiry. So here we can see, first in this letter we mention the address. After that, here we are going to give a salutation, like a respected sir, madam, like that. After that, here is one subject line. It means this is to inquiry about our marine officer who has been convicted by you. After that, here is the main important paragraph. So here we have to give the all details, like our officer John Smith is been convicted for murdering an American citizen and been imprisoned. So this is to inform you that Mr. John Smith, officer, is in our army from last 2 years and is from good background. So he is one of the brave soldier in our army. He has a prove his bravery by fighting and in Iraq and Afghanistan war. So in this way, in second lecture, we have to give the details about the inquiry. In last paragraph, as per our inquiry, Mr. John was trying to protect a girl from boys who were harassing her. For his own defense, by trying to push the victim away from the girl, and during the course, the victim met with accident. In this way, this is called as an inquiry letter. And in last, we have to mention, therefore I will request you to look into the matter and let me know for what Mr. John is being convicted. After that, we have to mention your regards, Jack Nicholson, General, US Marine. So this is the one example of inquiry letter. So you have to read this letter again, and if you want, you can write this in your notebook also. So here is also one inquiry letter. This inquiry is regarding research. So here we can see research inquiry letter. After that, we have to mention the address in detail. After that, we have to mention a subject line, like inquiry regarding my research. Research. After that, we have to write down a salutation. After that, here you can see two paragraph, like I am currently studying in XYZ business school, pursuing my MBA, and I am in a second year, and I have to give presentation on marketing field. In second paragraph, you can see I have read about your company on website and would like to research on your company. I want to know about the marketing process. Therefore, I request you to give me 1 day permission of visiting your company and allow me to inquire about the marketing process. So here we have to give the all details about the inquiry. In last paragraph, I would be grateful if you give me a chance to conduct the research. Please let me know about your reply at the earliest. And after that, we have to give line like thanking you, Graham Bell. So these two are the example of inquiry letter. So in that way, we have to follow the rules and regulation whenever we are going to write a inquiry letter. After that, here is the one some points about letter of inquiry. Like most example of this letter type contain three short paragraphs. Here you can also see there are also three paragraphs. After that, the first paragraph specific the subject of the inquiry and indicate why the inquiry is being made. So here you can also see here we are giving a subject line. Okay. So the middle paragraph lists the specific item or questions that the letter writer wants or wants answered. Usually the items or questions are presented in a bullet list form. And last paragraph tactfully indicate a deadline by which the item being requested or the answer the question need to be supplied. And last point is usually modify block with the indentation format is used with this letter type. So here you can see this is a modify block type of letter. Okay. So these all points are very important whenever we are writing a letter of inquiry. So student, we are going to repeat this. Most example of this letter type contain three short paragraphs. The first paragraph specifies the subject of the inquiry and indicate why the inquiry is being made. The middle paragraph lists the specific item or questions that the letter writer wants answer. Usually the items or questions are presented in a bulleted list form. The last paragraph tactfully indicate a deadline by which the item being requested or the answer to question need to be supplied. And last point is usually modify block with an indentation format is used with this letter of text. After that, here is a one example of order letter. So business letter for placing an order. Here is the one example. First, we have to mention from. After that, we have to mention a date. And whenever we are writing date on a which letter is a return, after that, we have to write to, and after that we have to mention a subject line like a order letter. After that, here you can see dear sir or madam, as per our discussion on, here we have to mention a date of meeting. We are pleased to place an order of order for 100 copies of Mastering Mathematics book by, here we have to mention a writer name, for class 7 for the ICSE board on the following terms and condition. It means in our first paragraph, we have to mention about the order, and in our second paragraph, we have to mention about the detail of our order. Like the cost of each book will be rupees. Here we have to include all taxes amount. After that, payment terms will be post dated check for 50% advance with order. It means we have to give all details about our order. After that, the check will be clear on the day of the deliver. The balance payment of 50% 7 days after delivery and after random inspection delivery by done within 7 days from the order date. Delivery will be done at, here we have to mention the address of organization. After that, if the order is not delivered as per the above terms and conditions, the order stand cancelled. In that way, we have to write any order letter. It means we have to give the all details about order when we are placing anything ordered. So please find enclosure check number. We have to give the check number. After that, we have to write a date. And after that, we have to amount which we are going to pay toward advance for the order, and hoping to have a long business relationship with you. Best regards. And here we have to give the name of the signing authority. So it means this is the best example of business letter for placing an order. So students, you can read this again, and if you want, you can note down this in your notebook. Okay. So in that way, first we discuss about inquiry letter. After, we discuss about a business letter for placing an order. here is the also one inquiry letter example. So you can also take the screenshot of this inquiry letter and you can fill up these blanks in your own words and you can revise the inquiry letter. So after that, we are going to discuss how to write a complaint letter. So when writing a complaint letter, you want to keep it short and to the point to help ensure that your letter will be read in its entirety. If you write a 7-page complaint letter, it's highly unlikely that someone will sit down and read all 7 pages. So we have to keep in our mind that our complaint letter should be a short and a pointable. So next point is the complaint letter should be addressed to the customer service, consumer affairs department or the head office if there is no customer service department. The address and the contact information of the customer service department should be available on the company's products or website. So a hard copy of complaint letter should be written in the business letter format, while an email should be sent in the same format but without the heading. So you all of take care of these points when we are writing a complaint letter. So this is the key points for how to write a complaint letter. So here you can see here is the one best example of complaint letter. Like first we have to give the address of the sender. After that, we have to mention a date of writing the letter. After that, we have to write a designation of the receiver. And after, we have to write an address of the receiver. So this is the most important thing when we are writing any complaint letter. After that, we have to give a subject line like replacement of defective TV set. So here is the one. Defective TV set. So we are going to give complaint about that. So after that, here we have to mention a salutation like respected sir or madam. And from after that, here is the main body start of the letter. So I, Manish Sharma, have purchased on LG TV set from your showroom on Feb 25, 2020 against the bill number 100-1001. But I regret to inform you that the TV is not working as it must. There are the following problems. So here we can mention, we have to mention the problems like the volume cannot be increased after a certain level or the picture turns black and white on its own after a few minutes of switching the TV off. And after that, the third paragraph, like I bought the TV set on your assurance that it will be of excellent working condition. The TV set that was shown to me, the same model at the showroom was fine working. And in that way, we can end the body ends and complimentary clothes.